Okay, we're at the 2019 March Horrorhound Convention in Cincinnati. We've got mock time toys over here, killer pillows, t-shirts, Five Nights at Freddy's toys, Horrorhound merchandise, just about anything you can dream of. We've already been through the vendor room once. This is our second sweep to see what we can find. So, if I can hold the camera, right? What? We will see what we can see. So here's Ghost Rider walking around. This is the Amok Time Toys booth. I already bought a couple things off of him. The new 1962 Godzilla Mecha. Let's see, he's got the Koto Bukia. Is that how you say it? $89.99 price on that. Most of his NECAs are $30. He's got some cool stuff, some Nightmare Before Christmas things, some boards. A lot of import Godzilla available for a mock time. Very cool stuff. Someday, if I ever get the budget, that's more what I might get into is the imported Godzillas. Nice big Godzilla going nuclear up there on the shelf. Let's go see how much he is.
That's good.
How much is that one? Just how much is that one out of curiosity?
200.
Hey, he's cool. Well, out of my price range. Unless I just want to blow all my con budget in one purchase. We've already been to meet Meatloaf, Robert Patrick, and we're waiting to go back and see Christopher Lloyd. So here's some cool masks. That is a very Shatner Halloween on the sign. Let's see, more toys, tons of toys. Proverbial kid in the candy shop here. There's all kinds of stuff that I want. Let's see, what do we got? We got Jason's mom's head back there. There's a little shrine to his mom. Friday the 13th Ultimate Box Set. Looks like it's got a Jason mask in it. I've never seen that set. $100. Let's see. I see a Ripley. I see more Godzillas. Some Freddies. We've got some loose figures down here. Let's see. Some very neat. Very neat custom work over here. I love these reanimator sets. Did I notice this one?
Do you have any?
It says "Cat Dead." Details later, West. That's great. I really like that. And the Phantoms and Spears. Very cool stuff. This is Mechner's Unlimited. I love the Phantasm Spear base that's got the motor.
That's okay, we just talked before,
there's
21 and about 7 minutes.
Driving to
Dallas is 24 hours. 35
for those?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And what you see is what we got, and I'm thinking by tomorrow afternoon we ain't gonna have much.
Right. Okay. We might circle back around. I like that.
Great, thanks.
I grabbed a card.
Everything that's okay. Reanimator green. Gross.
Cool.
How you doing, man?
Not too bad. That's
what we got? Oh, yeah. These are the, what are they called?
My Little Demons.
My Little Demons. Yeah. Those are cute.
I'm sorry.
Okay, more artwork here. This is Byron Winton's stand. I bought a couple of his pieces before, particularly the one that has all the characters in it that guys or ladies looking at. That's a good print. Got that hanging in my office. He's also got another one I'll show sometime. I can see it in the book. If you look up his website, that's Ash, Helena Through the Desert, in Christine with Michael Myers, Leatherface, Cujo, and Freddy Krueger. So pretty cool. Lots of t-shirts here. Let's see, anything you can, if you can put a monster's face on it, they have cups, key rings, enamel pins. We bought some of them earlier that we thought were cool. Here's some toys. There's a light up Ultimate Terminator. It says Hasta la Vista and all of that. It's kind of neat looking. I don't think I'd bother with it. I'm not so much into the vintage toy thing. I mean, maybe if I had it as a kid, I might want it for nostalgia. I got a few He-Man, and that's good enough for me. Let's see, posters, tons of posters. More shirts. Some over here stickers. There's one booth here that does all your favorite horror characters as cats. Cats is your favorite horror characters, rather, I guess. Let's see, across the top shelf there is a Phantasm soundtrack on LP.
Let's all get accumulated soon.
For $90. I've got that one hanging on my wall, autographed by Angus Scrim. Let's see, more posters, masks. I wish there was more Jason masks here and good looking ones. All of them seem to be that style you're seeing up there, painted different. I would like a good, accurate Part 6 mask if I had my brothers. Let's see, some very cool artwork here. Yeah, here's the cat. These are kind of cute. My daughter Kate eating man. There's across the top Pinhead, Jigsaw, Sam, all of their cats. Ash, Jason, the American Horror Story Clown. That's some cute stuff. And her booth is Earth and Wood.
He's gonna run.
Books. I bought a few books off this table before. They have a real neat book. It's up there on the sign. Hidden Horror. And it's 101 underrated and overlooked horror movies. That's a nice read. I'd recommend getting it if you can. Let's see. You hanging in there with me? Okay, she's having a good time, I think. She's in the search for a Chucky doll.
I think Brooklyn mentioned that she might be going.
Here's some crossover. I like this guy. We've done this before. So she's got that print of Corey and Momo's dad finding Jason. And I've got the print over there of Jason walking with an appearance going on. There's the Ninja Turtles from Pennywise, Charlie Brown fighting a thing, Snoopy and They Live, Woody and Chucky. We actually have a couple of yours. We got the Jason and then Jason with the Peanuts gang. Is it 3 for $25?
Yep, okay. $25. All my new stuff that I've done for this year is up here in front, so feel free to look through.
Okay.
I got a few more Jasons. I've done some Archie with Jason there.
Is that RoboCop?
Yeah, that's RoboCop. The Ultimate Tin Man.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, that was fun to make.
We just bought 3 prints from Screen Prints.
All right, I'm gonna go fetch Anus.
Get on his website and check it out. It's some really cool stuff.
He's a big dweeb.
Okay, you want to hold up what you got? Yeah, she got the Woody with the Chucky. Woody the Chucky, I got They Live, Charlie Brown, and Michael Myers with Charlie Brown. I told myself I wouldn't buy any more prints because I don't have the wall space. But, it's just too much fun. And those were too good. So, let's see. We've been down that aisle. More t-shirts, more magnets, stuff like that. Let's go to this back aisle where I know there's more toys. And you can see some of the selection going. Here's a booth from Synapse Films. Looks like they have some steelbooks. Steelbook of Popcorn, Steelbook of Phenomena. I bought a few things straight from them here. If you like some of the classic movies, they've got the Street Trash, Super Meltdown, Brain Damage, I know Synapse carries. So check out their website too. Okay, wrong aisle. Back here, here's another booth of a guy I like, Voodoo Comics. Soundtracks, comics, albums, vinyl. I bought the Evil Dead 2 colored vinyl off of him earlier for $30. Made me a deal, normally $40. So some more toys here. Yeah, she's after that Chucky doll for $100. I don't think we can swing that. I don't know if I'll say bootleg or not, but yeah, bootleg, because Bad Taste and Blood Beach, I know, are available on DVD, so you get a little bit out here. Here's some Blu-rays, they're bootleg. Kill Bill, The Whole Bloody Affair, which is the two movies edited together. Credits, so let's see. Extended animation scene, longer gore, no interruption between volume 1 and 2, credits have been deleted. You can find some interesting stuff here. Here's the toy booth I talked to earlier. They have a very nice Godzilla for just $100. Again, just out of my price range at the moment. So there's the Bride of Chucky set for only $50. He has the Dawn of the Dead Mezco set that I just bought for $100 instead of $120 I paid for it. So that was disappointing to me. I think we might end up getting something here. So I'm cutting back into some of the celebrity area. We got Jake the Snake Williams. There he is. Nick Foley. Signing autographs there. Lori Petty from Tank Girl. Holly Shore. The two hitmen from Breaking Bad. And two of the guys from Super Troopers. All here in the back wall. Down this aisle, we've got Steve Weber. I know him best from Wings. I guess he was in The Shining. I actually haven't watched the series. X-Files, Jake Busey down the way. Poncho Moore. John Franklin. Back there is the guy, I forget his name or his hand, the guy that played Roach in the Addams Family movie. He was also in Men in Black. So kind of a busy aisle.
Wait a second.
Yeah, the cop was in a rush for something. So there's Stephen Wolfram.
Sorry, I'm
just gotta like him from I'm drawing it. Forget the name of Rise Zombie. Oh my god, he's the bad guy in Rise Zombie. So I think maybe with this, so here's some more cool artwork. There's Godzilla, there's Return of the Living Dead, Ash, Jason, some good stuff. but getting busy in here, a little hard to film and talk and not run into people. So I think with that, I'm going to let go. And this was your tour around the vendor room of Horrorhound. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. So there was one more thing here that I had to show you all. Off of this booth of the Living Dead Museum and Gift Shop.
You have like a hair tire?
Oh, you should.
One thing very neat that they have is Ash Chainsaw Christmas ornaments. I think that's very neat. Don't want to blow all my money. I bought a Phantasm Sphere one and see where I live. And here they have pieces of the cabin with certificates of authenticity, the cabin from part two. Very neat, just wanted to share that. Another celebrity room, we got Tom Atkins. There he is back there. PJ Souls from the original Halloween. Jefferson Hall and Rhiann Reeves from the new Halloween 2018. And James Jude Courtney in the back, who played Michael Myers in the new Halloween. And of course, more artwork, more posters. So, again, some very neat stuff, some very original stuff. A lot of talent here at the show.